Welcome to Cooking with Amar. Today I'm going to be making chicken carnitas. Generally they use pork, I'm going to be using chicken, so you can see how delicious it can be. I'm going to be using chicken dark meat, so it'll be thighs. It'll be juicy and succulent and very flavorful. So to start with, I have a large stainless steel pot, and then the ingredients I have are 6 allspice, 2 bay leaf broken, 1 teaspoon of salt, 6 black whole black pepper, 2 teaspoons of sugar, and 6 garlic pods. If you notice, they're whole. I'm not going to peel them. It's okay because it's going to dissolve. The flavor is going to be extracted from that, and we're not going to be eating it anyway. It will be drained out. We have 1 onion sliced crosswise, and we have 2 oranges. The juice of them and the orange will be put in them. Again, we're not going to be eating them. We're just going to remove the chicken at the end. We're going to be using 1/2 a can of evaporated milk here. I have Carnation evaporated milk. And then, of course, we have a tub of lard. So, as you can see, it's going to be cooked in this lard, and it won't have a problem. We're also going to add 1 cup of water in it. I'm going to dilute 3 teaspoons of chicken bouillon. This is to add moisture and flavor. Now, why we add water to lard? You say that oil and water don't mix. Well, in this case, it does. And the water is to keep the chicken from burning. Right, we'll be back in a few minutes. I'm going ahead and add the lard, and we're just going to melt it. Can't add anything until this comes to a clear mixture. So we'll be back after it melts, and I'll show you what else we're going to do. All right, we're back. As you can see, the lard is completely melted and it's clear. If it's not clear, it might be bad. We're going to go ahead and add the chicken pieces. Now, you can do the chicken with skin or without skin. This is here without skin. Be careful not to just drop in there. I'm going to go ahead and add the chicken first. I'm letting it be flat, one layer, and then I'll let settling see the rest on the pieces. We want them layered. A little bit of skin is okay. It'll crisp up. Add a little bit of crispiness. You can add all with skin, or little skin, or no skin at all. Alright. And I'm going to go ahead and add garlic. As you can see, the garlic is whole. I don't have to worry about peeling it. Garlic. 2 teaspoons of sugar. 1 teaspoon of salt, and 6 peppercorn whole, 2 bay leaves broken up. Now, you don't have to break it up. I break it up so it distributes well. And then 6 allspice. All right. I'm going to go ahead and put the onion in there. It may fry and stuff, that's okay. So we're going to add more liquid to this. So again, everything is layered, not dumped one on top of the other. And now I'm going to go ahead and do the oranges. I'm going to squeeze the oranges directly in the pot. And if you notice, this is a big orange. So be careful how you squeeze it. Do it slowly, otherwise it's going to splat on you and burn. You could do it directly in the pot, or you can just do it in a container and pour it. Okay. So it's squeezed and goes directly in there. Let's do the rest. If you don't get all the orange juice out, that's okay, because it's going to come out by itself. So the peel and everything goes in, and you say, oh, it's going to be bitter. It won't be bitter. Juice is going to flavor the chicken very, very well. Careful not to get burnt. Be careful that doesn't spray out on you either. Everything is layered, as you can see. Don't pile it up one top of the other. Just like that. As you can see, it won't splatter. The lard is hot and appears to be fine. But you do it slowly, so you don't get burnt. All right. Okay. I've gone ahead and finished processing this chicken after it's been cooked. I place it in the tray here separately. And then I broiled it for 5 minutes on each side. I took it out, flipped it over, and I put some liquid on the chicken so it'll add some flavor. So after it cools, take it out of the container tray, and it's ready to eat. This can be eaten with rice and beans. It can be eaten by itself as a snack. You can see it's beautifully roasted. Now, I'm going to show you also some of the skin is also roasted, so it adds a nice flavor, nice crunch.
Right there. Okay.
And here's your finished product.